Ông quên chỗ.
President, please be seated. The court is back in session and the floor is given to the deputy co-prosecutor to put question to this witness. Please wait.
Co-prosecutor,
you may now proceed, Mr. Cope.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Your Honours. We have a request. We would like to make some oral submissions either at the end of this afternoon or tomorrow morning before we continue with this witness or at the end of her testimony in relation to the very recent disclosure of new statements that was notified to us 2 or 3 hours ago, and also in relation to the upcoming hearings at the Supreme Court chamber. I leave it to your wisdom as to what would be the appropriate moment, but I just would like to inform you that we have that request.
Le moment le plus judicieux pour cette demande, mais nous souhaitions la formuler. Merci.
Can I just ask a question for clarification? This has nothing to do with this witness.
Puis-je vous demander une petite précision? Cela n'a rien à voir avec ce témoin, n'est-ce pas?
President, the chamber grant your request and you can make an oral submission at the end of today, before the end of the day.
Avant la fin de l'audience.
You may now proceed, Deputy International Co-Prosecutor.
Le co-procureur international adjoint a maintenant la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President. Let me just update you on where we are. We will finish our questioning at 2 o'clock today. The civil parties hope to finish in 40 minutes. It is possible. They tell me that they may need an additional 15 minutes. I hope that that won't be a problem since we have today and tomorrow to finish the witness. I'd rather that we just proceed until see if we finish by the break rather than deliberate on this now, but I wanted to alert you to that. Madam Witness.
Madame le témoin.
I have one follow-up regarding what you told us this morning about the 1st January dam. You told us that there were some occasions where you would spend the night and sleep at the 1st January dam work site. My question to you is, on those occasions, did your husband sleep at the same place as you, and if not, where was it that your husband would stay on those nights?
J'aimerais savoir où votre mari passait lui ses nuits sur le site.
Answer.
Réponse.
At that time, my husband did not come to stay with me. We stayed in different places at that time, even in the same work sites.
Y compris sur le même chantier.
The last subject I want to cover with you today concerns the purge of the Central or Old North Zone. We talked earlier today about one of the party cadres who served with your husband on the North Zone Committee, Toll, the Secretary of Sector 42, who was the one who appointed you to Chamkarlu, to the Chamkarlu District Committee. Can you please tell the court what happened to Toll during the Khmer Rouge regime?
Sous le régime des Khmer Rouge.
Answer. I did not know what happened
Réponse.
To him
Je
at
sais
that
pas
time.
Ce qui lui est arrivé à l'époque.
Uh, Did Toll,
question.
Was Toll arrested or Toll did he disappear at some point in 1977?
Disparu à un moment ou à un autre en 1977?
Yeah.
Answer.
Réponse.
I did not know whether he was arrested or he disappeared.
Je ne sais pas s'il a été arrêté
ou s'il
a disparu.
I did not know when he was arrested and what happened to him.
Je ne sais pas s'il a été arrêté et ce qui lui est arrivé.
For the record, Your Honors, document E3/2956 is a prisoner list from S21, titled List of Persons from the North Zone. Number 42 on that list is Chan Mol, alias Toll, Sector 42 Chairman, who entered S21 on the 19th of February 1977. Madam Witness, were there other cadres from the old North Zone
Madame
who
témoin,
also disappeared in
1977. D'autres cadres de la zone nord ont-ils disparu en 1977?
Answer. It seems that I do not recall
réponse.
It.
Je ne m'en
I do not
pas.
Recall the catchphrase from those central and north zones.
De la zone centrale, de la zone nord.
Let me see if I can refresh your recollection, Madam Witness.
La mémoire, Madame le témoin.
I realize that you are unable to read. So I will just describe for you that there are documents from S21 that record the arrest and execution of hundreds of cadres from your zone in 1977.
E3/2956,
the list I just mentioned that includes Toll, identifies a total of 94 North Zone cadres, mostly people from the zone, sector, and district level,
nord,
who were arrested and sent to S21 between mid-February and the end of March 1977. And document E3/3861 is an S21 execution list titled List of Prisoners Smashed on 8 July 1977, North Zone. It identifies 173 prisoners from your zone who were killed at S21 on a single day, the 8th of July 1977. Madam Witness, did you not notice in 1977 that
Madame
virtually
témoin,
every North Zone cadre at the zone and sector and district level disappeared
nord,
and was replaced by people
disparu,
from the Southwest zone?
Et ont été remplacés par des cadres de la zone sud-ouest.
President, please hold on, Madame Witness. You may not receive
attendre,
Mr.
Témoin,
Copé.
Maître Copé a la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President. I object to the word disappear.
Maître Copé. Objection par rapport à l'emploi
that
du
word
terme
is being used all the time.
Disparu.
Sometimes appropriately, sometimes
ce terme
inappropriately.
Est employé en permanence, parfois
prosecution has
à
just
dessein,
read out a list of arrests and alleged list of executions. Hence, these people
les
didn't disappear.
Sur une liste,
so I would like
the prosecution
to rephrase
disparu,
the question and not use that word
disappear. Sa question, ne pas employer le terme disparu.
I'm happy to rephrase, Mr. President.
Pas problème, Monsieur le Président, je peux
Madam Witness, were you not
Madame
aware in 1977
n'étiez-vous pas au courant,
that virtually every single cadre at the zone, sector,
zone
and district level was
nord,
taken away,
zone,
killed, and replaced by people from the Southwest zone.
Et remplacé par des membres de la zone nord-ouest, nord, sud-ouest, pardon.
Yeah.
Answer. I may not have known.
Réponse.
I noticed people were gone, but I did not know where they were going to. I knew only Tol. And for the rest, I have no idea.
Let me read to you what a couple of people close to you had to say about this. In OCIJ interview E3/375, English ERN 00360752, Khmer 00348791, French 00369914. The in-law that we talked about of yours, Ban, Poss, who served with you on the Champkar Lu District Committee, testified as follows, quote, after purges were conducted at the central zone, only four main people survived.
Kepok,
Ying Cham, Un, and me. All others were smashed. Sou Soeurn, my older sibling-in-law and Kepok's wife, was the committee of Champkar Lu district. End of quote. And this is what your husband had to say in his interview, E3/2782 and 2783, ERN English 00089713-714, Khmer 00095552, French 00596211. I quote your husband. In June 1977,
the
first stage of capturing was over. By that time, only me remained, and the central zone had no cadres left. The upper brothers decided to transfer cadres from the southwest zone to fill the unoccupied positions. They sent about 200 cadres from that zone. End of quote. Madam witness, do you remember the arrival of cadres from the southwest zone who came to take over and replace the old North Zone cadres?
Les anciens cadres de la zone nord.
Answer. I could not recall it.
Réponse. Je ne m'en souviens pas.
Do you know how your husband felt about the old North Zone cadres being purged and replaced by cadres from the southwest?
Par rapport au fait que ces cadres étaient remplacés par des cadres de la zone sud-ouest.
Answer. I do not really understand about
réponse.
That. As I said,
je ne comprends pas très bien.
He had a different business to do, and
comme
I had my
dit,
own.
Nous ne nous occupions pas des mêmes choses.
Well, let's talk about someone that was in your district, Madam Witness.
Qui était dans votre district, Madame le témoin.
Number 6803 on the OCP revised S21 prisoner list. This is document E3/342 at 00329891. Number 6803 on that list is a person named Nguyen Ruyn, alias Tiang, who is identified as the Champkar Lu District Secretary and Sector 42 Deputy Secretary, who entered S21 on the 1st of October 1977. Do you remember a cadre named Tiang who served as Champkar Lu District Secretary?
Qui aurait été secrétaire du district de Champkar Lu.
Answer. I heard of the name Tien, but I have never met him or her personally.
Was this person not the secretary of Champtarlu district?
Ne s'agissait-il pas du secrétaire du district de Champtarlu? Secrétaire du comité?
Answer. When I was a member in that district committee, I never noticed that name. Perhaps I may have forgotten.
Peut-être que j'ai oublié.
I knew only Ban and three others, but I could not also recall the name of the three individuals.
Des noms de ces trois autres personnes.
Let me try a few other names from Champtarlu district, Madam Witness. The S21 list I mentioned earlier, E3/2956, numbers 70, 71, and 72 on E3/2956 are all cadres from Champtarlu district who were sent to S21 in March 1977. The three names I will read for you: Mak Hyang, Eng Hor alias Sin, and Sok Pal alias Sem. Did you know any of those people, Madam Witness?
Answer. I only knew the individual by the name Sim, and for the rest, I do not know them.
Je ne connaissais pas les autres.
What happened to Sim?
Question. Le président.
President, please wait, co-prosecutor, you may not proceed,
attendre,
Mr. Copé.
Le co-procureur, Maître Copé a la parole.
A remark. In regards to
une petite remarque
previous question about Tien,
à propos de la question précédente concernant Tien.
I cannot reproduce it right now, but we have information that he might have been a cadre in Tangkok district rather than in Champtarlu.
Plutôt que dans le district de Champtarlu, mais je ne peux pas produire ces informations pour l'instant.
Mr. President, I'm not going to respond to that. There are other sources.
We
can have this discussion and debate at another time. Sem, you mentioned that you knew Sem. Can you tell us what happened to Sem in March
1977?
Answer. I did not know the reason why he parted from the place where I worked with him.
That is what
I recalled at that time.
Voilà tout ce dont je me souviens à son propos.
Madam Witness, do you know whether it was your husband, the zone secretary, who decided to arrest the North Zone cadres, or whether it was the party leaders in Phnom Penh who made that decision? Are you able to tell us that? Who was responsible for making decisions about the arrests of the cadres?
Answer. Allow me to inform the court that I do not have the full graph of the information. My husband had different tasks to perform, and I had my own to do. I have no idea about his business and tasks. What he was doing at that time, it was under his under his responsibility
and asked.
For me, I was his wife and I did not know and I was not involved in the arrest
or
any kind of things.
Let me read to you what your husband had to say on this subject.
Again,
this is from E3 2782. And 2783, ERN references, Khmer 00095552, English 00089713, and French 00596211. This is what your husband said in his interview.
Quote,
when I was conducting an assembly in Region 41, a messenger from Phnom Penh arrived, telling me to get prepared for inspection mission in various locations. However, as I arrived in Phnom Penh, I met Pol Pot and brother Nguyen Chea. They showed me documents of all regions and ministries. Furthermore, the answer was too clear to correct. Continuing below, I said, it is difficult to say because all comrades are life and death friends. However, if Ankar has decided already, I do not have any complaint. Some soldiers served me since 1968, but they were accused of being CIAs. I did not know what to do except telling them I just put them forward for the higher level. Upper brothers. End of quote. Madam Witness, I realize this is a difficult subject to discuss. However, you were a member of a district committee, your husband was the zone secretary, your brother was the sector chairman. Did your husband ever talk to you about his meeting with Pol Pot and Nguyen Chea and the instructions he received about the arrests and purge of cadres in the North Zone?
Answer. I repeatedly told the court that my husband would know his business
and
I minded only my own business. So I did not know about his contact or relation with Ankar Le.
Je ne savais rien de ses contacts ni de ses relations avec Ankar d'en haut.
Thank you, Madam Witness. My national colleague just has a few questions for you to follow up.
Mon confrère national a quelques questions à vous poser.
Co-prosecutor, good afternoon, Mr. President,
parties,
everyone in and around the courtroom. My name is Seng Lien. I am the deputy co-prosecutor of the national side.
Je suis le co-procureur national.
Due to the time, I have several questions to put to you, Madam Witness.
J'aimerais vous poser quelques questions, Madame le témoin.
This morning, you stated that you selected and chose people from cooperatives in order to send them to work at the 1st January dam site.
Sur le chantier du barrage
you
du
stated
janvier.
This at around 10:36 minutes.
Vous l'avez dit vers 10h36.
I would like to seek your clarification on this matter. Could you elaborate on the selection of people to work at the first January dam site? How did you select people? Answer. I chose and selected people from cooperatives to work at the first January dam site.
Envoyer travailler sur le chantier du barrage du 1er janvier.
I did not personally select and chose the people.
Moi qui ai choisi personnellement
the Songkat chiefs were the ones who selected people from their Songkats.
Qui ont choisi des gens au sein de leur Songkat.
Co-prosecutor.
Le coprocureur.
Could you clarify for the court whether Songkat was the same as commune?
Songkat, cela voulait dire commune, c'est cela?
Answer. In the previous time, it was called Songkat, and now
we call commune. Songkat, mais désormais
the Songkat was the one who was in charge of their own people.
Était en charge des gens co-prosecutor, qui vivaient.
Could you tell the court?
Question.
How many Songkats were there in
Chamkale district? Il y avait dans le district de Chamkale.
Answer. I do not remember how many Songkats were there in the Chamkale district because it has been a long time ago.
Cela remonte à trop longtemps.
I was about 40 or 50 years old at that time.
J'avais 40 ou 50 ans à l'époque.
So I could not recall it.
Je n'arrive pas à m'en souvenir aujourd'hui.
Co-prosecutor, thank you.
Merci.
About selecting people, how many people were selected
de ces gens qui
from each Songkat?
Choisis au sein des Songkat. Pourriez-vous nous dire
answer.
Combien ils étaient par Songkat?
People were selected
réponse.
First from the cooperatives, and the list was held by the district committee.
Le comité du district établissait une liste.
For example, one Songkat may have selected 20 to 30 people from the cooperatives. I was not the one who held the list, and as I stated, I was illiterate, I could not read and write, I was not the one who held that list.
Ce n'était donc pas moi qui pouvais tenir cette liste.
Question.
Question.
You stated also this morning that
vous avez également dit ce matin
you were in charge of leading people and bringing them to work at the first January dam site. Could you clarify for the court on this matter?
Pourriez-vous nous en dire plus à ce sujet?
Were you at the first January dam site constantly with the workers?
Étiez-vous sur le chantier du barrage du 1er janvier aux côtés des ouvriers?
Answer. I was not there constantly with people, but I went there once in a while to visit my workers. I was not there constantly or always with the workers. Sometimes I would go to visit my workers for 1 or 2 days, and after that I would return back to my place.
Suite à cela, je rentrais chez moi, là où je travaillais.
Question. If you didn't go to the work site frequently, did you assign any of your immediate subordinates
si vous
to regularly stay with the workers at the first January dam work site?
Avec les ouvriers sur le chantier?
And for the forces from the cooperative, they will be under the supervision of the cooperative chief. Likewise, people or workers from the commune will be under the supervision and management of the commune chief. For me, I didn't go there to have a direct supervision over those workers at the work site.
Question.
If you did not go there regularly,
si vous n'y alliez pas régulièrement,
what happened if each of the commune chief had to make a report?
Si
did they have to make a report directly to you or to someone else?
Comptes, faire un rapport directement à vous ou à quelqu'un d'autre?
Answer. For the reporting process, they made it through the district chief.
Les rapports étaient
for instance,
présentés
on the number of workers
exemple,
at the work site, as they already had a list with them.
Travail, ils avaient déjà une liste avec eux.
Question. Did you ever receive any report
avez-vous jamais reçu un quelconque rapport
dealing with the working conditions at the first January Dam work site
sur le site de travail
from any of your subordinates?
De la part de l'un de vos subordonnés.
Answer. They had their own respective chiefs.
Ils avaient chacun leur propre chef.
And they would make such a report through the commune
et
chiefs, and each commune chief would be responsible
of
to deal
chaque
with those
chef
issues.
De commune était responsable de traiter ces questions.
And if I were to receive such a report directly,
si
I would instruct the relevant commune chief to deal with those issues or to give them what they needed in terms of tools or food. However, usually there was sufficient as Encar provided them with enough material. Question. In the case that you received a report
question.
On the difficulty or the difficult situation at the work site,
et si vous
what did you do with the
report?
Did you have to make a further report
travail,
to the upper level?
Vous en faire vous-même rapport à l'échelon supérieur?
Answer. Once I received such a report, I discussed the matter with the district committee, and the district committee then reported to the sector.
A alors fait rapport au secteur.
Question. And when you received a work plan from the upper level,
et lorsque vous receviez un plan de travail de
did you have to, how do you disseminated such information
comment
through the cooperative workforces at the first January Dam work site?
Communiquez-vous aux forces de travail des coopératives du barrage du 1er janvier?
Answer.
Réponse.
On the issue of work plan from the upper level,
au sujet
the
du programme
district
ou du plan
committee
de travail de l'échelon supérieur,
held
le
a meeting
district organisé
and
une réunion
sent relevant workforces to
et
the first January Dam work site. And frankly speaking, the district itself or myself did not remained directly to supervise or to lead the workers at the first January Dam work site. As we also had to lead people to work at various other dams and canals at various other work sites for the district. And I usually supervise such a workforce.
Je supervisais en général ce type
so I did not really have a detailed knowledge
de
on the conditions at the first January Dam work site.
Au chantier du barrage du 1er janvier.
Question. In the interest of time, I have my last question to you.
Ma dernière question pour vous.
You were the one responsible for sending workers to the first January Dam work site. What kind of tools and equipment you provided to them?
And
I didn't send any tools or equipment, as there were sufficient tools and equipment, including hoes, axes, and earth-carrying baskets at the website. I only organized the workforces to go there, and they had to be self-sufficient with the tools and equipment. Question. So from what you said, those workers only utilize hoes and axes for the construction of the dam. Am I correct in saying so? And they didn't have any access to other equipment or tools?
Ils n'avaient pas accès à un quelconque autre équipement.
Answer.
Pour construire le barrage. Réponse.
The workers at the first general dam work site only had their personal strength with axes, with hoes, carrying a pole and baskets and knives. And if they had sufficient food, then they had the strength to carry the dirt. Deputy Co-Prosecutor, thank you, Mr. President. I don't have any more questions. I'd like to hand the floor to the lead co-lawyers for a civil party. President, thank you. The chamber now hands the floor to the lead co-lawyers for civil parties to put questions to this witness. You may proceed, counsel.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour à tous. Avant
Thank
de donner
you,
la parole à ma consoeur Chet Van Lee, je voudrais
everyone.
Vous
Before
confirmer, Monsieur le Président, que nous souhaiterions avoir une vingtaine de minutes supplémentaires
you,
pour nous
like
permettre de poser les questions que nous avions souhaité poser. Il est déjà 2h10 maintenant, donc c'est la requête que nous formulons. Et je laisse la parole à ma consoeur tout de suite.
That is the motion that we are making, and I now give the floor to my colleague.
President, yes, the chamber allows that, and the assigned counsel, you have the floor. Counsel Chip Van Lee, good afternoon, Mr. President, Your Honours, and everyone
Bonjour,
in the courtroom. And good afternoon, Madame Sou Soeurn. My name
Bonjour,
is Chip Van Lee. I'm a lawyer for civil parties.
Bonjour, Madame le témoin. Je suis avocat pour les parties civiles.
This morning, you testified and clarified some points before this court.
Vous avez apporté un certain nombre de précisions.
However, I have some additional points that I seek your clarification.
J'aurais besoin d'un certain nombre de clarifications sur quelques points.
You are the wife of Kai Bok,
Vous êtes
who
l'épouse
was
de Kai Bok,
a zone secretary.
Secrétaire de zone.
And besides his role as a zone secretary, did your husband hold any other positions?
De secrétaire de zone, votre époux occupait-il une quelconque autre fonction?
Answer.
Réponse.
Regarding his duties at the zone, his other main task was to lead workers to work at the first January Dam work site, and that's about all. Question. This morning you testified that sometimes you came to Phnom Penh to visit your husband. Did your husband have any specific role or function in Phnom Penh?
Occupait-il une fonction ou avait-il un rôle en particulier à Phnom Penh?
Answer. I did not say that I came to visit my husband in Phnom Penh.
Je n'ai pas dit que j'étais venu rendre visite à mon mari à Phnom Penh.
That is from my recollection.
D'après ce que je me rappelle.
And there was no requirement for my husband to stay or to be stationed in Phnom Penh, as his work involved mainly at the central zone at the time.
Son travail principal concernait la zone centrale à l'époque.
Question. This morning you said that you came to Phnom Penh and you met Pol Pot.
À Phnom Penh et que vous avez rencontré Pol Pot.
Did you meet him in a personal capacity or was it a formal meeting where you had to meet him to receive instruction?
Au cours de laquelle vous l'avez rencontré afin de recevoir des instructions.
Answer.
Réponse.
I did not come to Phnom Penh for a personal reason, only when I was called by Angkor to come.
Je suis venu lorsque then I came. Il m'a convoqué.
It Alors was all related to my work, and it's not a personal
travail.
Affair.
Il ne s'agissait pas d'une affaire personnelle.
Question. You said that it was all related to work. What kind
vous
of work can you
tout
tell
était
us?
Lié à votre travail. De quel travail s'agit-il? Pouvez-vous nous
Answer.
Le dire?
For instance, I was called by Angkor to attend the meeting
réponse,
to receive the work plan for various districts and communes. And I did not go there alone. There were thousands of similar capacity to attend the meeting to receive instructions regarding work plan and work distribution for each district. Commune or cooperative, respectively, and what we had to do to resolve the issues with the people. That was the kind of work I referred to.
Au sujet de ce que nous devions faire par rapport à la population.
Question.
Voilà les instructions
as a wife of Kai Po,
en tant que femme de Kai Po,
were you aware who were his superiors?
Saviez-vous qui étaient ses supérieurs?
Answer.
Réponse.
I only knew that Pol Pot, Nguyen Chia,
je ne connaissais que Pol Pot, Nguyen Chia et Khieu Samphan.
Besides them, I do not know who else.
Je ne savais pas qui d'autre.
Question. Did you know how he communicated with the upper level, for example, via his personal messenger or via telegram?
Par exemple, un messager personnel, utilisait-il telegram?
Answer. At that time, telegram was not used, to my knowledge, and the communication went through his messenger. The messenger would go between Kampong Cham and Phnom Penh to relay messages. And of course, at that time, there was no telephone or mobile phone. And telephone was, landline phone was used only when there was such explicit instruction from the upper Angkor. Otherwise, messenger was a common form of communication.
Était donné. Pour cela, tout le reste des
Question.
Passait par messager. Question.
Besides attending the meetings,
en dehors,
what are the
réunions.
Means of communication that your husband did in order to report to his upper echelon?
Quel autre moyen de communication utilisait-il pour faire rapport?
I did not know the details of his work or the process of any other communication.
Je ne connais pas ni le processus ni les procédures en matière de communication dans son travail.
Question. I'd like now to touch upon the first January Dam website.
À présent aborder
Does the name Sou ring a bell to you?
Ou est-ce que le nom Sou vous dit quelque chose?
Answer, no,
réponse,
it
non.
Doesn't ring a bell.
Ça ne me dit rien.
question, what about Cham and Soka?
Et qu'en est-il de Cham et Soka?
Answer, I know Cham.
Je connais Cham.
As we used to stay together, he was his messenger.
Nous habitions ensemble, nous avons séjourné ensemble, c'était son messager.
And I cannot recall the name of the other person.
Je ne me souviens counsel. Pas It's du Soka. Nom de l'autre personne. L'avocate, c'est Soka.
And I cannot recall who Soka is.
I forgot about this name. J'ai oublié ce nom.
Question. Can you tell the court who was responsible for the construction of the dam? Was it Cham, or was it Soka, or was it another person? Answer. For such detail, I did not have a full grasp.
Je n'avais pas un aperçu
complet. I only know that the first January dam was organized by Ankar.
C'est que c'est l'Ankar qui a organisé le barrage du 1er janvier.
Question. Please tell us if you can why
si vous le pouvez,
the dam was so
dire,
called the first January dam and what was the purpose of its construction?
Et quel était l'objectif de la construction de ce barrage?
Answer.
Réponse.
Through my understanding, the first January dam was organized by Ankar for the purpose of blocking the water for the irrigational purposes for the people living in the area stretching to Barai area. That is all I understand about its purpose.
Voilà comment j'ai compris l'objectif de la construction de ce barrage.
Can you also tell the chamber whether you were present on the day of its opening inauguration ceremony?
Jour de la cérémonie d'inauguration.
Answer.
Réponse.
I was there attending the inauguration ceremony.
J'étais là à la cérémonie d'inauguration.
Question. How was the ceremony organized?
Comment For instance,
was a speech given? And who were the dignitaries
in the
inauguration ceremony?
À l'occasion de la cérémonie d'inauguration.
Answer.
Réponse.
It has been a long time, and I cannot recall the details. I cannot recall who made the speeches at the time.
Je ne me souviens pas des personnes qui ont prononcé un discours à cette époque-là.
Question. Could you please try to recall at least the names of senior leaders who were present there on that day? That is attending the inauguration?
Qui était présent à la cérémonie d'inauguration.
Answer. I
Réponse.
Only recall my husband.
Je me souviens
and
que mon mari
I
était là.
Cannot recall the rest since
Je
I have a bad memory these days.
Car ces jours-ci,
of course, there were senior leaders and there were also cadres at my level, but most of them have died.
Mais la plupart sont décédés.
Question. What was the process of the inauguration that is from your personal observation?
D'après ce que vous avez pu voir.
Answer.
Réponse.
I was there, but I cannot give you any detailed
là,
description of the entire process.
Mais je ne peux pas vous donner de description détaillée de l'ensemble du processus.
Question. This morning you testified that you went to the first January Dam work site and a while ago, in response to the co-prosecutor question, you said that you also visited the first January Dam work site. My question to you is the following. During your trip or your visit to the work site, and allow me to add that workers there, as you said this morning, slept on a proper floor and the food was sufficient. And you also made your comment on the sanitation, that there were no proper latrines and there were flies as people relieved themselves in the open. Can you tell the chamber the total numbers of the workers at the work site?
Quel était le nombre total de travailleurs sur le site du barrage?
Answer. As I stated this morning,
réponse, comme je l'ai dit
the first January Dam work site, workers slept on on a floor. It was not a kind of a proper floor made from bamboo, but the floor was made from small trees or branches of trees. And through my estimation, there were between 20 to 30,000 workers working in total at the first January Dam work site. And probably that is a very modest estimation. There could be up to 40,000 workers. And in terms of sanitation or people relieving themselves, you can make your personal imagination, even in your family of 3 or 4 members, sometimes sanitation is an issue. And you could imagine that when there were 30 or 40,000 workers, so people resorted themselves to relieving themselves in the open, and that was the issue dealing with the sanitation.
Question.
Did you make any observations regarding number of workers who fell ill?
Au sujet du nombre de travailleurs qui tombaient malades.
Answer.
Réponse.
From my observation, there were some people who were ill. Due to the number, the excessive number of workers at the work site, and due to the sanitary issues and large number of flies, the medicine at that time was merely enough, as we only just came out of the struggle, and we only liberated the country not for long. Question. In terms of workers who were seriously ill, were they treated on the spot or were they referred to another hospital?
Sur place, ou les a-t-on envoyés à un autre hôpital?
Answer.
Réponse.
For seriously ill workers, they were sent to a hospital for treatment at the Kampong Cham province. There was a state hospital in Kampong Cham.
Question.
This morning you also testified that in your capacity as a member of the Chamkale district, you sent people or workers to the first January Dam work site.
Au site du chantier du 1er janvier.
Were those workers composed of both male and female? And can you also tell the court the kind of people you sent? For example, were they regular force or were they old people or younger youth? Answer. As for the forces we sent to the work site, I already said this morning, it was the cooperative chief, and the communities who recruited those workers. They were the regular force workers, meaning that they were at the range of age between 20 to 30 years old. However, sometimes there were also younger people around the age of 18. People older than that would remain at the cooperative.
Question.
Regarding tools and equipment, and you said this morning that the Ankar supplied the workers with those tools and equipment. What about food? Did Ankar resolve the food issue, or did you yourself at the district level make your own decision in terms of food distribution? And what about clothing?
De la nourriture. Et qu'en est-il des vêtements?
As for clothing, it was the state who distributed it.
Pour les vêtements,
and people had sufficient clothes to wear.
De la distribution. Les gens avaient
they
suffisamment
at
de
least
have
one
ils
set or two sets of, sometimes three sets of clothes.
Tenue, deux tenues, parfois
and
trois Anka tenues.
Had a responsibility to assist with the food supply. But I cannot tell you the details of how it was organized.
La nourriture, mais je ne peux pas vous donner de détails sur la façon dont tout cela était organisé.
Question. As for the workers who were sent to work at the work site, was there a mechanism for a rotation? For example, 50 workers were sent there and later on another group of 50 workers would be sent to replace them. Yes, there was a rotation process. For example, workers had to work there for a limited number of months, then they were replaced. For instance, workers at the age of around 18 or 20 years old will be replaced after a certain period of months working there, and then they will be transferred to work at another work site dealing with dam or canal construction at the district level. Question. This morning you also testified that at that work site people disappeared, including both the best people and the 17 April people.
Ou de personnes du peuple de base.
What about the workers that you sent from your district? Was there any disappearance amongst those workers?
Des disparitions parmi ces travailleurs?
Answer. There were disappearances of both best people and 17 April people, and when I asked about their disappearance, I was told that they were sent for re-education. Questioned, and did those whom you were told that they were sent for re-education ever return? Answer. They were sent for re-education, and some of them returned, while others were said to be sent to live in another district.
Mais pour d'autres, on nous disait qu'elles ont été envoyées vivre dans un autre district.
While you were at the work site, what was your observation regarding the general situation of the worker?
À la
for example, were the workers enthusiastic in doing the work?
Par exemple,
for example, were
travail?
They smiling while they were working? And
exemple,
what was their health condition?
Quel était leur état de santé?
Answer. They were neither skinny
réponse.
Nor fat.
Ils n'étaient ni gros ni maigres.
as they were provided sometimes with cooked rice or gruel, as food supply was sent from Tonle Sap. But you cannot compare the food condition to the food we are eating these days. They were also given some dessert, and there were also dry fish for them. And that was my observation when I went to the work site. Of course, I cannot describe every aspect of the food condition at the work site. Question. And while again you were at the work site, did you observe any use of heavy machinery to aid in the workforce? Answer. As I said, I did not stay regularly at the work site.
However, je ne séjournais pas régulièrement sur le site.
There were no heavy machineries, namely a tractor used, only human strength and workforce was used to carry the dirt, and only later on heavy machineries were involved.
Question.
In terms of the working hours, when did it start and when did it stopped, and were there any resting times in between?
Fin des heures de travail et éventuellement pause entre temps.
Answer.
Réponse.
In the morning, sometimes they ate some food.
Le matin,
however,
parfois,
sometimes they had to start working early, and
parfois,
since we did not have a watch, I could not say exactly what time they started
montre,
working, and I might say it
might be
around 7 o'clock in the morning, and they stopped
matin.
Around 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Question. After you completed work, was there any
question. Une fois que
livelihood
le travail est terminé,
meeting in the respective
y avait-il
units?
Des réunions de vie au sein des unités?
Answer. It appears that there was
réponse.
No livelihood meeting. I could not recall it.
Je ne me souviens pas de ces réunions de vie. Je crois qu'il n'y en avait pas.
They
une fois que le travail
went back
était terminé,
to their places.
Les ouvriers
I could not recall it because it has been a long time ago. As I
pas.
Stated, I have had
car
a weak memory so far.
Et ma mémoire me fait défaut.
Perhaps after the meetings, workers went back home, went back to their places.
Council. Après le travail, les gens
thank you, Madam Witness. I would like to seek your clarification concerning the
question.
Plan of work or work quota.
J'aimerais obtenir des
what
précisions
was the
concernant
work quota?
Le quota de travail.
How,
quel était le quota
many,
respecté?
How, what is the work quota and how much land was required for one worker to do?
Answer.
I do not have the full graph of information. I do not know whether the land was measured by cubic meters and then it was assigned to workers. I do not know how much soil was required for workers to do.
Combien de terre les ouvriers devaient transporter?
Counsel, thank you, Madam Witness. I would like to move on to another
question. Merci, Madame le témoin. J'aimerais
topic.
Passer à un
I would
autre
like,
sujet
before
présent,
I do that, I would like to read the statement, EON 00348832.
Dans le procès verbal d'audition,
in French,
00 36 78 08.
You stated
08.
at that time, I saw pagoda was turned
vous
into a hospital and monks were disrobed and forced to leave
que les moines
the pagoda.
Qu'ils avaient dû quitter la pagode.
Why
la pagode
did Khmer Rouge eliminate the religion and where did monks go?
Pourquoi les Khmer Rouges ont supprimé la religion, aboli la religion, et nous dire également où les moines
Answer.
Sont allés par la suite?
I was in the forest at that time. I had not
réponse.
Been
J'étais dans la
living
forêt à l'époque.
In the district yet. I
Je
do
ne
not recall
pas encore dans le district.
When it was.
Je ne me souviens pas de quand cela s'est produit.
When I arrived, I saw that
Lorsque
the pagoda
arrivée,
had no more monks.
J'ai vu qu'il n'y avait
monks
plus de moines
had
dans
already
les
been disrobed.
J'ai
and
vu qu'ils
I do
déjà
not
été
know
défroqués.
Either where monks were sent to.
Mais je ne savais pas où
As
ils avaient
I
été
stated,
envoyés.
I was living in
Comme je
the
l'ai dit,
forest.
Je vivais dans la forêt.
At that time,
à ce
I
moment-là.
Had not been living in the district yet.
Je ne vivais
Council.
Pas encore dans le district.
Thank you very much, Madame Winnes.
Question. Merci
for the
beaucoup,
interest
Madame
of the time,
Thérouin.
I would like now to seek the floor for the international colleagues.
Je vais maintenant céder la
President,
parole à ma consoeur
thank you. You may now
proceed. Le président.
International lead
Merci.
Co-lawyer.
Je vous en prie, yep. vous avez la parole, Madame la co-avocate principale internationale.
Je vous remercie,
Thank
Monsieur
you,
le Président.
Mr. President.
Bonjour, Madame le
Good afternoon,
Je m'appelle Marie
Guiraud
et je suis l'avocate qui représente le collectif
the lawyer representing the
des parties civiles dans ce procès.
In this trial.
J'ai quelques courtes
I have
questions
a few
de
brief
suivi
questions,
à vous poser
a brief
sur le barrage du 1er janvier
to put to you with
et j'aurai ensuite
to the
quelques
January
questions
dam.
Sur la question des mariages
and then I'll have
pendant
a few questions,
le régime du
Cambodge
démocratique. Concernant les travailleurs sur le barrage du 1er janvier, vous avez expliqué
you
à ma consoeur tout à l'heure
a little earlier
le système de rotation
the
et que c'était les chefs de communes qui choisissaient les travailleurs qui partaient sur le chantier et puis qu'au bout de quelques
and
mois, ces travailleurs
months,
rentraient pour être affectés à d'autres tâches.
To other tasks.
Je voulais savoir
so
s'il arrivait que des travailleurs
times,
rentrent
workers,
en dehors de ces périodes de rotation.
Come back outside of these rotation
Est-ce que vous avez vu à l'époque des travailleurs
then,
qui rentraient
coming
au village,
back to the village
en dehors des périodes de rotation,
of the rotation
que vous avez
cycles, that
un petit
you
peu
described
plus tôt
a little bit earlier on this afternoon?
Answer.
There was a replacement and there were candidates or reserve workers to replace those who had been working in the, at the 1st January dam site. And those who were removed from the 1st January dam site were sent to build the dam at Chomkale district.
Ont été envoyés construire un barrage dans le district de Chomkale.
Donc si je comprends bien
so
votre réponse, c'est que les personnes
well,
qui ont été retirées du barrage du 1er janvier sont allées travailler sur un autre chantier. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris?
Did I understand you clearly?
Yeah.
Answer, yes. They
oui.
were sent to Chomkale to build dam,
Ils ont
the
été
canal,
envoyés à Chomkale pour construire un barrage,
so that,
des canaux,
we could have a feeding canal
pour qu'il y ait
to bring water
des canaux d'alimentation
into the field.
Pour pouvoir irriguer les champs.
Je vous remercie. Est-ce qu'il
Thank
arrivait
you.
Que des personnes malades rentrent
would
au village pour se reposer
ill,
ou étaient-elles envoyées à
would
l'hôpital?
They, go back to the village, or would they be sent to the hospital?
Answer. I do not know about it.
Je n'en sais rien.
For the sick in my district, they
Les
were sent
qui étaient
to
dans mon district
a hospital.
Étaient envoyés à l'hôpital.
I do not know about the sick at the 1st January dam site. I do not know where they were sent to.
Je ne sais pas où ils étaient envoyés.
Est-ce qu'à l'époque, vous étiez au district,
when
vous étiez arrivé de voir des personnes malades qui étaient au chantier et qui rentraient dans les différents villages ou communes de votre district.
Different villages or communes.
Est-ce que c'est quelque chose dont vous avez le souvenir?
Is this something that you remember?
Answer.
What I remember that sick people at the 1st January dam site were referred to the hospital, and after they recovered, they would be sent back to the cooperative or work sites.
Renvoyés sur le site de travail ou dans les coopératives.
Je vous remercie. La raison pour laquelle je vous pose cette question, c'est que nous avons entendu un petit peu plus tôt dans la semaine une partie civile qui a travaillé pendant trois mois sur le barrage du 1er janvier, qui venait du district de Prague-Prosop, un district différent du vôtre, et qui nous a expliqué que les personnes malades rentraient dans les villages pour se reposer. C'est en tout cas ce qu'on expliquait aux travailleurs. Si je comprends bien de ce que vous nous dites aujourd'hui, dans votre district, les personnes n'allaient pas se reposer au village, mais étaient envoyées à l'hôpital. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris votre déclaration position cet après-midi?
Correctly.
Answer. Yes, and for those who were seriously ill, they were referred to Kampong Cham Hospital, and after they recovered, they would be back at work in the cooperatives.
This is my recollection. Voilà ce dont je me souviens.
Okun.
President, thank you.
Le président, merci.
It is now a convenient time for the break, but before
nous allons we à présent faire
take
une
the
petite
break,
pause.
I would like
mais
to
cela,
ask Mr. Copé
whether
he would like to submit orally in relation to your request.
Faire son intervention. Vous présenter sa demande.
And I do not know how much time you would need for making your oral submission. We would like to be informed so that we could arrange a short portion of time for your submission.
Nous pouvons vous accorder un bref moment pour vous entendre.
I suppose it's only Mr. President, a few minutes.
Monsieur le Président, je n'ai besoin que de quelques minutes.
Just expressing our concern
in respect
of the latest
disclosure,
specifically the upcoming segment of the Kampong Cham Airport.
Concernant le prochain segment,
this particular prosecutor is in the courtroom, so I'm sure that he'll be able to answer all kinds of questions. But I think 5 minutes should be enough.
Je pense. Je crois que nous aurons besoin de 5 minutes seulement.
Thank you.
Once again, it is now a convenient time for the short break, and the chamber will take the break from now until 3 p.m. Court officers, please facilitate a proper place for this witness and TBO staff during the break time, and please invite them back to the courtroom at 3 p.m. The court is now in recess.
Suspension de l'audience.